character and qualities of Andy Day, reflecting his hard work for his constituents, his good humour, and certainly those of us who remember his natural modesty. But among this, I also took into account the council encouraging younger members onto this council. Reflect the communities that elect us, and also it's important that we reflect the diverse nature of the communities we serve. The person council receiving this reflects those qualities as a young, hard-working member who campaigns regularly on behalf of his community. As the youngest member in this chamber, and possibly the youngest member ever in the since the creation of Wirral Council back in 1974, great pleasure in announcing that the award tonight goes to Councillor Warren Ward.
Thank you. welcome the news that unemployment levels have fallen to 1.58 million, down from 106,000 this year, over the past year, and down 925,000 since 2010. They're lowest levels since 2005. And does the leader of the council welcome the latest NOMIS figures showing just 2.1% of rural population claiming out of work benefits? That's where with regards to the comments on investment. Further to the council's attempts at nipping and the associated press release, can he give members a list of the council's £100 million worth of land and assets that he'll be putting into the Wirral Growth Company? And can he give us an assurance that none of these sites will be within Wirral's Greenbelt? And to Councillor McLachlan under Transformation, can the Cabinet Member for Transformation confirm that the Council has or will spend as part of a Transformation Programme £188,129 on a programme manager, a further £181,471 on a second programme manager, £139,080 on an interim head of transformation, the transformation director, interim head of transformation, a paid £665,760 to Capita, and £185,000 to companies providing economic and legal advice to set up a joint venture company. And does she consider this £1.3 million spend to be good value to the council and taxpayers?
consolidating the council's own civic requirements on the site, real secure public sector underpinning for a commercial and civic quarter with potential for up to 60,000 square metres of office and ancillary commercial space. When can the council get details of these outlined to them so we can actually discuss these projects and find out what's going on?
Councillor Allen.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Unfortunately, considering myself a leader of the council, I'm at the call-in meeting where the owners of small business explained in detail the detrimental effect the parking charges would have potentially on their businesses. And the 45 jobs provided by those particular organisations. Can the leader please take the time to just explain to us how parking charges in parks will make these small businesses thrive? Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Can Councillor Wilson, the Cabinet Member for Public Health, give us more information on the Move On Up programme, which supports local rural people coping with mental health issues, part of a range of excellent services we continue to provide for our most vulnerable citizens? Thank you.
Councillor Powell.
My question relates to comments in the report of Council Living on infrastructure. In Castlebridge, we have been blessed with the Highways Department spending several months constructing four drop curbs and four pedestrian refuges at the roundabout on Castlebridge Road, in the process causing massive disruption to motorists. Normally, we would be delighted with so much attention and colossal spending. However, there is a problem. All the drop curbs are on grass verges, which after 20 feet become ditches, not a footpath in sight. Can I ask two questions? Firstly, are we providing parachutes for pedestrians to reach this roundabout to use these drop curbs? Secondly, why and who decided on this colossal waste of money when half a mile away we have a road called Beachway, a main cut through from the motorway, which is subsiding at one end, and the rest is a patchwork of potholes? We have tried for the past 5 years to get this road resurfaced. We have had residents' petitions, and many residents have written to the Chief Executive, all to no avail. A fraction of the money wasted on this roundabout could have been used to resurface this road rather than being spent on this roundabout, which has never seen a pedestrian and never will, as it cannot be reached safely and confidence. Thank you, Mr.
joint venture company will be undertaken through a series of workshops contracts that many people have to now exist on, and a refusal by the government to do anything about that. I think they should hang their heads in shame. On the issue of parking charges, Councillor Elderton and Councillor Mitchell asked about this. As we've said many times, David, the only reason why we're here is your government have cut our budgets by £150 million since 2010 and another £132 million between now and 2020. So if you don't want parking charges, can I advise you to go back to your minister and persuade him not to impose these draconian cuts, or at the very least give us a sweetheart deal?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Council. So, and we have obviously modified our proposals around parking charges, and for businesses, we have listened to what businesses have said. For the businesses in the parks, we've introduced a membership system for people visiting the parks, so parking works out at about £1 a week for parking in parks, which I think is a very reasonable deal. But I think the answer to both of the members' question is persuade your government not to cut our budget.
No, 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 no.
During the week, Mr. Mayor, the Wirral team met with 40 separate investors and developers who expressed an interest in Wirral. We're now going to be following up all of those inquiries, and as I mentioned earlier on, we're going to be putting a full business case to Cabinet in May. There'll be members' workshops to understand the detail, and I am aiming to be in a position by the end of the year where we have our investor partner, and most importantly, we will see some development by the end of this year, beginning of next year. So I think, finally, Mr. Mayor, the important message from the conference last week is that Wirral is open for business. We have a clear vision. We are ambitious to attract new investment and jobs. And we are keen to move at pace to turn our vision into reality. We are not going to sit on our hands and do nothing like the party opposite wants us to do. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Transformation agenda in this council has been borne out.
to ensure that the fabric and those buildings operating effectively will be looked at now as we go forward into the second phase of this work. And of course, members will be fully involved in that process through pre-decision scrutiny, through any task and finish work that will occur before the FPC comes to Cabinet in June. Thank you very much. Thanks.
Thank you, George Davis. No more questions.
And I'd like to thank David for his question. And fitting into the good quality housing that these residents needs is where you get your question from, Pat. In terms of progress towards the target of bringing 250 empty properties back into use, I fully support the point of view about the demolition of other properties, i.e. public housing, which have been left to go to back in the room, in particular another one I think you're talking about in Tramway, Victoria Lodge. These things are progressing, to be honest with you, quite well, and what we have done is got our funding into place. We made some really good city region as part of the start of our building and housing zone status. And having a housing zone status gives us a lot more priority to access the government funding opportunities. And so therefore, I think when we see the sector licensing scheme that we have already taken care of and are working very well with, it's been an absolute tremendous success with 1,270 properties, which represents over 99% of normalised support properties. And I think that following that route in terms of empty properties and bringing them back into use, together with, as you say, public houses, they can't be used just on the basis that someone says, I want to put flats. A good example of that was applying the last gas plan when on Lurch Street, the old police station, and totally inadequate, didn't fit the bill. One of the questions that's been raised by Lewis, and I'll be fully supporting that, and so the Labour group, is the fact that good quality housing is what we're talking about. That would never ever be good quality housing, whether it's shared bathroom, shared the whole thing. It only brings in, to be honest with you, we're looking for the under 35s to come into an area. And I don't know if only it fits into what we're looking for. So I would suggest that we need to look very, very closely at what we do, in particular with the pubs in the area. Quite a few of the goals, quite a few of the different way of investments and bringing them forward. I think we need to look at them very, very close on that before we make any conscious decisions. I hope that answers your question. Thank you.
Thank you. Councillor Christine Jones.
Thank you. press release that goes out, but I can provide a written response if you can provide me with a question. The third point was from Ian Lewis. Again, I think not in the report, but again, happy to address it. He mentioned, he was a bit bizarre mentioning that, because I'm only a member of one constituency committee. I think it was Councillor Pilgrim, who's not here this evening, who raised in a previous meeting that it would be good to celebrate the work that all the committees did, so that it was a response directly to the request of Councillor Pilgrim, and I know other councillors want to ensure that their work's done. I do celebrate all the work done across the Wirral. His specific question, again, not mentioned, was related to Wirral View. And I will, before I ask Sergeant to give advice on this, I will just say, because it's important, because it's been mentioned a few times this evening, about this is the panacea, get rid of this, we can fund everything. Well, essentially, we used to spend more money and reach fewer people. Then we left the poorest people in this borough in the dark. Wirral View allows us to spend less money and reach everybody. So,
please have some more of it. Come on. Listen to the question.
So I think spending less money and reaching more people is a responsible choice, and I think then to spending more money and reaching fewer people and leaving the poorest in the dark is the wrong choice. And specifically relating to the question.